Bubs. So today's video is going to be an overview of some BB creams. While some people like to collect lipsticks, eyeshadows, I like to collect BB creams. So I'm gonna go through some of my favorite BB creams and some BB creams that are okay and then some that I don't like. It's been a while since I made a video and it's just because I've just been so busy. Her name is called Chubbi. You can call her Chubs or Chubs Cutie. She's like my psychic, like Bubs and Chubs. Isn't that right? Okay. First of all, I'm just gonna let you guys know what BB creams are. Now, BB creams basically means either blemish balm or beblish balm. It's the same thing. And even though it is so popular in Asia, it was originally formulated in Germany. The BB creams are supposed to provide coverage, moisture, sun protection, and some actually help to improve the texture of your skin, such as aging, dark spots, acne. I would say the only disadvantage with BB creams is a lot of them only come in like one or two shades. The fact that it contains a lot of SPF, it could really make your face like ghastly. It would definitely be a good thing if they have more color ranges. Okay, so let's get started. This one is the Skin 79 Super Beblish BB Cream. I've heard a lot of good things about this BB cream and to be honest, I'm not surprised why it does everything a BB cream is supposed to do. You would pump this and then product comes out, so it's pretty hygienic. I like the coverage, it's pretty good, very easy to smooth out. You only need a tiny bit goes a long way. This BB cream works well whether you apply it with a brush or a your fingers. The cream has a nice texture. As you can see, it's very easy to blend. And once everything is blended in, it actually doesn't feel sticky and oily, which is one thing about BB creams. A lot of them can feel pretty sticky. There's SPF 25. And it's also got wrinkle-free properties. While I can't really say much about whether it has helped wrinkle improvement on me, I can say that it has helped to lighten my dark spots. So that's a really great thing. This one is actually also a Skin 79 BB cream. So it looks like this. I was supposed to buy this one, but I thought, oh, you know, I'll pick up this one as well. But I actually ended up liking this one a lot more. I like the texture of this one more, and I think it blends nicer. It improves the skin tone, it helps to lighten dark spots. But this one actually specializes in wrinkle improvement, so it helps to tone your skin. I've been noticing like my forehead area doesn't have as much dry lines ever since using this, so that's a great plus. It does the exact same thing as this one does, but the only difference is it specializes in toning the face. So I do like this one more. Someone out there who's looking for a BB cream with good coverage, gives you moisture, protection, everything, the whole package, then I definitely recommend these two. Okay, so next up is the Misha Watery BB Cream. And you guys have heard me talk about this a lot. I've used this many, many times. It's actually one of my favorites. I love the consistency. It's so light and watery. This BB cream is perfect for days where you just don't want to wear much makeup. You want a little bit of coverage. You want your face to feel moisturized. You want it to look natural, then you should wear something like this. So as you can see, it's really watery. But it's almost like airbrush makeup, and even though it is very light, it's definitely buildable. If you're someone who doesn't really like heavy coverage, then I recommend using something like this. This is great for evening, you know, redness in your face. Next BB cream is from Lioele. It is the Triple Dissolution BB Cream. Now, first of all, this is actually sent to me by Lioele, so thank you so much for letting me try it out. When I first tested this on my hand, I remember thinking, okay, this is really heavy and thick. But what I realized was a little goes a long way. And when you use it with a foundation brush, it spreads really well, gives you fantastic coverage. Another thing I really like about this BB cream is that it doesn't like to peel. For me, this much is enough, just a tiny, tiny amount. As you can see, you would think it's really thick, but it goes a long, long way. It blends really well, your face will look so flawless. You like how the packaging is a pump, so it's hygienic. Definitely would recommend this if you're someone out there who's definitely looking for coverage. Next BB cream is the Lioele Water Drop BB Cream. Now, to be honest, after using the Misha Watery BB Cream, I'm really liking it. I thought, you know, this would be great. I guess it's just more of me preferring my Misha one more. While I can say it's very moisturizing, gives a really nice, healthy, dewy finish, it does not really provide any sort of coverage at all. I think this would be a great product if you already have great skin and you're just looking for an extra boost so your skin appears more dewier and healthier. But if you're someone who has acne scars or, you know, blotches, then it's probably not the cream for you. This is the Laneige BB cream, and especially, you know, for me, I am a huge fan of Laneige cosmetics. I was, again, anticipating this one. To say, I was very disappointed with this product. Two shades of this, and I bought the natural one, and even still, it was so white on my face. I tried applying just a little first, so it wouldn't look as white, but it still didn't look good. Some form of shimmer in this, so you know, it had that really weird, like pearly look that I really didn't really like. It's a shame because I love the texture. There's nice coverage. It's just the color is way, way off. Next up is the Osley Rose Hip HD Flawless BB Cream. So I bought this because the word HD stood out to me. It's pretty long lasting, so that's good. Remember when I was just applying it on, the consistency wasn't very consistent. Sometimes it would come out in like blotches, sometimes there's loads of water. Maybe it's just my one, but that was a big downside for me for this Osley BB Cream. It's not the best BB cream, but you know, again, it's not the worst. It's just average. Next up is the Misha Cover BB Balm Pack. So this one actually has SPF 50, and it looks like this. It has a mirror, you have your sponge, and then your product that you lift inside. See, you lift inside. And to be honest, I don't really use these anymore. You're always dipping back and forth, and it causes bacteria, dirt, and everything to build up inside. Yes, they are handy because you can just pop them in your bag on the go and just touch up whenever. I mean, there's a massive mirror. Once you apply it on your skin, it has a creamy consistency, but once it's blended out, then it turns liquid, which is pretty cool. Nice coverage, it's buildable, and doesn't look too cakey. So I do like this one out of like a lot of compacts. This one would probably be one of the ones that I would use. A lot of people were asking about this one, which is the skin food one. Personally, I find it a little too thick and quite difficult to blend. Not very good if you have dry skin because your skin may end up looking flaky. The very last one, you guys already know, the infamous Signature Real Complete BB Cream. I don't like this one because because it made my skin itchy. I kept scratching and it broke me out. I didn't want to believe that this was a bad product, so I kept trying it, but it just, every time I used it, my face was itchy, it was scratchy, my face looked ashy. Everybody has different preferences. These BB creams are just used out of my experience, so I can't speak for everybody. Some people like really little coverage, like almost nothing, so it's dewy. Some people like heavy coverage. We just have to work with whatever is good for you. So I hope that was helpful, and I shall speak to you soon. So remember to subscribe to vlog channel to see more videos of little Chubbi.